Well, welcome back to the Steve Rob Show. Today, I got a little bit of a project and a quick tip on the best degreaser, I think, in the world for this particular type of job. I'm working on some cast iron and I found this to be the best degreaser. It's a little rough, but for me, it's the best low-cost degreaser compared to most of the other products out there. I'll show you what I got going on down here on the bench. And let's get to it. Okay, so what we got going on here is my old vise up at the camp. I had mentioned in a couple of vids back there that I broke it. And this is the vise that's off my workbench over there. And I'm going to bring this one here up to the camp. And all I did was strip it all down and, take it all apart and everything else. And I'm going to prime it with the Krylon primer. But if you take a look right here. I mean, that was such a buildup. I think they dipped these vices in something on the ends before they paint them, because it's almost like body filler. It was so thick. I mean, you could see how thick it was there. I think they used that to hide the pores, in the castings. But I'm going to prime this up, and then I'll get back to you with it primed, and then I'll paint it, and then I'll show you the degreaser that I use. So let's get to it right now. Okay, so here we are. We're back, and I got it all primed. I'll show you it primed, and I just thought I'd let you know this is what I'm going to put on for the paint, and it's pumpkin orange. And let's take a look, and let's see how this turned out, and I'll show you a little modification I did before I paint it that I did to the vise. That I think it's a good mod. And let's take a look right now. Okay, there we are. And I tell you, that Krylon does a fantastic job. I only waited like about 20 minutes. But if you take a look down right here. Now that used to be like just a couple of pins that went through there. And you tighten it down because that's a swivel vise. And I had more problems with that because that's all it did was move around on you all the time. You can never get them tightened enough. So I took the pins out and I welded a nut on the top. And it's very rare that I have to swivel that vise. But if I do, all I have to do is get my ratchet out there and loosen them off. But there she is right there. And I'll get back to you next when we have the orange paint on there, or pumpkin orange. So let's get to her. Well, here we go. She's all done. She don't look too bad, eh, guys? And if you use up follow the channel, you're going to see that vise up at my camp. And I'm going to bolt it down to the workbench in the camp, because I have to have a vise up at the camp. Okay, so let's just wrap this up here. So what did I use to clean that vise with? And guys, it stripped it like real clean. All I did was just rinse it off with water. I put the primer to it. And guys, I use that whole can of paint. When I use a can of paint, I use a whole can of paint. And this is it right here. And I can see it clear as day and you can't. Okay, here it is here, guys. This is it, easy off. Yeah, this is the stuff that you use for, I guess, the old-fashioned ovens for cleaning your oven. And who did I get this tip from? My wife. Yes, one day I'm out here and I'm trying to clean some parts and I'm using this degreaser stuff that I got from the store and it ain't working. So she brings out the can of off. Easy off. And I'm going, okay, I'm game. I'll use it. I'll try it. Guys, I've been using this for years. It's just fantastic. Be careful what you're doing with it. Read the instructions. And it does a great job of stripping it right down, like big time. I get this at the dollar store up here. It's pretty cheap. I'm not too sure how much you're going to pay in the rest of the world. But there you go. That's a little tip here for today. Come back again. If you haven't seen this channel before, feel free to subscribe. Let's have some more fun. Bye, guys.